there's a lot of madness that's going on in the world today. You have powerful nations at war, hinting at the possibilities of a nuclear warfare. You have a downturn in the world's economy. We're dealing with global disease outbreaks. In major cities, there's been a rise in crime, and there's even rumors of a possible food shortage. When you hear all of this chit-chattering and things like that pops up on your feed, it can be quite overwhelming. If you think about it, it's depressing, it can trigger anxiety. What do you do to just keep your peace of mind, a sense of calm, remain hopeful and keep the faith? And yeah, that's what I wanted to do. I just wanted to share one of the things that I apply in my life that has helped me to maintain my peace of mind. It's actually really simple and requires little effort. What I like to call it is a Keep the Faith playlist. It's basically a collection of inspiring, uplifting songs. So there's actually a book in the Bible that does exactly that, and that is Psalms, which is a collection of poems and songs that are used to praise God, to, you know, just question God's plan, just cry out for help, lament. I'm not particularly a traditional spiritual kind of song person or spiritual hymns, but they are modern songs that do just that. Modern songs that are uplifting and still uphold some of the values of the Bible. And that's what I wanted to share. When I'm feeling just overwhelmed and just at my lowest of low, and I'm just like, ah, it's over, you know, hopeless. One of the things I do, well, let me just take you through it. Like, I fight. That's one of the things. I always have a desire to want to keep going. So I wake up in the morning and I might grab a fragrant shower steamer, just take a nice warm shower, grab my waterproof Bluetooth speaker and play my playlist. There's been times where, I mean, it just recently happened. I just was dealing with something that was just so overwhelming, and I'm in the shower and it just brought me to my knees. I have my playlist going on and I just get this strength, this motivation to keep on going. And it really works out for me. So I just wanted to share it with you guys. When you are feeling hopeless, it's like if you're at the gym and you're lifting weights and something that you used to do, you know you can knock out, but there's a time when you lift something and it's like you just don't have the strength. You cannot in this moment lift it. You do not have the strength to lift that weight. You're like, okay, it's over. I'm finna die. Out of nowhere, someone comes just running over and gives you a spot. That is the same thing that God does for us. God is the ultimate spotter. So when we don't have the strength, remember, believe in God, because God has the strength to lift and handle every burden that you may be going through. Music, music, music. I love music. Music is a very powerful medium. And because of that, you have to be mindful of what you expose yourself to, especially when we're dealing with impressionable or undeveloped or easily influenced minds. I know for me, it's very influential and impactful. I remember a time that I was outside, I was at the gas station, and there was a car in front of me. I'm behind that car. The car leaves. Now someone pulls up behind me and doesn't realize that there was a car in front that left. So they're like, why did I park there? Why don't I just move up? And they got irritated and they basically called me the N-word. Yeah, that wasn't too good. I just heard the drums of my ancestors. I'm like, you finna get an ancestral beat down. You know, I'm like, oh no. But as you can see, I have Sade on my t-shirt. Prior to that, I had already been working on things to keep my composure, things to remain and have a calm, peaceful temperament. So when I step out into the world, I'm not on 10, I'm on like minus 10. So when any unforeseen event comes into my world that can possibly challenge my peace, I'm prepared for it. And one of those things was me just listening to not only Sade, but a lot of calming frequency, peaceful frequencies. And that's why I was like, okay, this really works. Because if not for Sade, sir, you would have got punched in your face. I'm just saying. But I'm a change man. So let's get into my Keep the Faith playlist. And I'm not going to share the entire playlist, but I want to share a few of the songs that are my favorite. And the first one is Lauryn Hill, I Gotta Find Peace of Mind. I really love this song. It starts off with this quest, I gotta find peace of mind, and a search, a hunger to find peace of mind. But at the same time, dealing with outside clutter and energy that is trying to cause self-doubt, telling you that something is impossible. But the reply, because of a steadfast in faith, is I know it's possible. So later on in the song, the quest is answered. I found my peace of mind through God. God is my peace of mind. It's just a song that gives praise to the mercy that God has given us to have a second chance, to heal from pain. And I really love the transparency and the rawness. There's a point in the song where she even make a technical mistake. I love that because we are flawed and that's reality. And then also towards the end, she gets so emotional that she is crying, and I just love this performance. So let's get into it. Lauryn Hill, I Gotta Find Peace of Mind.
I gotta find peace of mind. I gotta find peace of mind. He says it's impossible, but I know it's possible. He says it's impossible, but I know it's possible.
So I'm gonna move ahead.
You're my peace of mind.
So this is the section of the song where earlier she was trying to find peace of mind, and now with God, she realizes that God is her peace of mind. It's, yeah, just powerful, powerful, powerful lyrics.
He's my peace of mind. What a joy it is to be alive.
What a joy it is to be alive.
Get another chance, yeah. Every day's another chance to get it right this time. Every day's another chance. Oh, what a merciful, merciful, merciful God. Oh, what a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful God.
So the second song on my Keep the Faith playlist is from Mary J. Blige, My Life. And I played this song into the ground. I was going through a tough time in my life, and it was one of the songs that just gave me the strength to keep on pushing. Very inspirational. With this song, I like it because it highlights that transparency. You know, sometimes we like to wear a mask. And one of the lyrics is, when you're feeling down, you should never fake it. Say what's on your mind, and you find in time that all the negative energy will cease. So I think it's important to be transparent in order to heal or in order to get help. So I really like that. In the lyric, it goes, you know, and you'll be at peace with yourself. You won't need anyone else except for the man up above. So just refraining from trying to seek validation from man and just seek your validation from God. So I really loved it. So let's get into Mary J. Blige, My Life.
When you
want to fast forward to this other part. Oh my gosh, this song is, whoo.
Cause he'll give you peace of mind. Yes, he would. And you will see the sunshine. For real, yes, you would. And you'll get to free your mind.
So again, just like in, Lauryn Hill, Gotta Find Peace of Mind, that praising God and acknowledging that God is the answer for peace of mind. The next song on the Keep the Faith playlist is Love by Music Soul Child. And I just enjoy this song. And a fun fact is that this song was originally a gospel song. So all you have to do is change the word love to Lord and you'll see the true origins of this song. But let me just share the lyrics. So it goes, love, so many people use your name in vain. Now, when you change it to the original, Lord, so many people use your name in vain. Lord, those who have faith in you sometimes go astray. Lord, through all the ups and downs, the joy and hurt, Lord, for better or worse, I still choose you first. Absolutely love. And even when you use love, God is love, so it's all good. Let's get into Music Soul Child, Love.
Love.
Choose you first. Mm-hmm. So there's a high note in this song. Killer. Let me see if I can find it. Hold on. Mm-hmm. It's in the bridge. Man, I love this. I love this. Music Soul Child love. Oh man. Always makes me smile. And I just, again, I love the lyrics, you know, just those who have faith still go astray. And just to remain faithful to God through the ups and the downs. Oh. Food for your soul. Okay, let's get on to the next one. Next song on my Keep the Faith playlist is No Gray by Jonathan McReynolds. And this song to me is one of my favorites. Very, very, very profound, impactful lyrics. The song is about that decision you have to make, that fork in the road of leaving behind the ways of the world and walking the path that God wants us to walk. And it's such a difficult decision. A lot of people are hesitant because the misconception that you're gonna leave back all of this prosperity and fun or whatever. Someone dared to me, introduced me to this song. It helped me to reaffirm that I made the right choice, because before I found God, I was a man of the streets. So I always struggled, you know, relapsing or wanting to go back to the ways of the world. So this song really helped me to stay firm. Like, okay, there's no gray, boom. You gotta make a decision and stand on it, 10 toes down. So I love this song, No Gray. Let's get into it.
Lord, I'm split in two. Part of me loves the world and the other loves you. So What do I do? I wanna be safe, but I gotta stay cool too. And no, I'm not a fool. I know eventually I'm gonna have to choose. And really, I don't wanna lose my ticket into heaven and a chance to be used by you. And if it's God that I'm after, I just can't serve two masters. And before something happens, I gotta turn it all around, because I know I can't just have my cake and eat it too. Cause it's really easy to stay on the fence and still do you. And it'd be cool if we could love the Lord and still go do our thing. See, it doesn't work like that. You gotta be white or black. See, I've realized when it comes to singing.
Oh yeah, no gray. If you get a chance, check out the lyrics of this song. It is so impactful, especially if you're struggling with making that decision to leave the ways of the world, because it certainly reaffirmed that for me. Next up on the Keep the Faith playlist is a song called Holding On by J Moss. I just like that. It's just straight to the point. You know, the lyric talks about the life of being a Christian. Sometimes it feels unbearable. The pain is so incredible. You don't feel like you have the strength to hold on. It makes you want to cry. It makes you want to shout. Just the road of walking a life as a Christian is sacrificial. It's sometimes entails righteous suffering. And what do you do to hold on? What do you do? How do you hold on? How do you keep on holding on? And that's what this song is all about. So let's get into it. J Moss, Holding On.
Sometimes it makes you want to cry out. Sometimes it makes you want to scream and shout. Sometimes you feel like it's unbearable. Sometimes the pain is so incredible. Why do I feel the way I feel being a Christian now?
It's not supposed to be this way.
But who said that it was going to be easy?
Who said it's going to be? Who said that?
Just straight up, raw.
The answer is Jesus. Sometimes in my own personal life, I'm like, I don't even want to do these videos, or I'm just tired, and how do I hold on? And the answer is, I just want to fulfill my purpose and my mission that was assigned by God. And that's the answer. That's the answer. So next up on the playlist is a song. This one might be a little controversial, might get me canceled, you know? I only got 2 subscribers, so it might go down to 1 after this. The song is You Saved Me by R. Kelly. And before I even get into it, let me just say I am an individual that's able to separate the message from the messenger. And I believe that the truth is still the truth, regardless of how it's said or who's saying it. Now, the song is You Saved Me, R. Kelly, and it's basically a song that entails different human experiences. The first one is someone dealing with alcohol addiction. They get in an accident, and years later, they are able to conquer their addiction. So God has saved them. Another story is a thug or a drug dealer. He's living that life. He gets shot. On his deathbed, he gives himself to God, and God spares his life. And he is saved. The one that resonated with me is a story about cancer, because I have people in my life currently that is battling cancer right now. My prayers goes out to them. they know who they are. The person battling cancer in the song, years later, God saved them and they are entirely cancer free. Basically, this song is just about the power of God saving and that you can, if you believe, change because God is merciful, God is forgiving, and no matter what you're dealing with, remember that God saves. So let's get into it. R. Kelly, You Saved Me.
And I'm at the grocery store with a pain in my chest and I'm wondering where did it come from.
I got tested
and the results came back and the doctor said, I'm sorry, but you got cancer. I cannot believe it, so I called up my mama to calm my nerves. She got down on her knees. She said a prayer for me. Said, just keep on thanking Jesus. He'll give you all me. That was 5 years ago. Don't have that pain no more. Doc says you can go home. Cause all your cancer's gone.
Said, you saved me.
No.
R. Kelly, You Saved Me. This is the last song that I'm going to share in the Keep the Faith playlist, and it's called We Fall Down by Donnie McKirklin, and I love this song. It pumps me up. The lyrics are, we fall down, but we can get back up again, and a saint is just a sinner who fell down. And I like that because sometimes we make mistakes. We can be harsh on ourselves. We can be unforgiving. And I think this song reiterates that God is forgiving and we should extend that forgiveness not only to ourselves but others. And it reminds me of the parable in the Bible, the parable of the unmerciful servant. I'm not going to dive deep into that, but basically you can find it at Matthew 18, 21 to 35, if you want to check it out. And in the beginning, Peter asked the Lord, how many times should I forgive someone? 7 times? The Lord responds is, not 7, but 77 times. So if we calculate that, that's about 490. So it's not to say once you get past 490 that you stop forgiving or you hold a record or account of someone's wrongdoings. The meaning behind it is that forgiveness should have no limit. And the same forgiveness that God extends to us, we should extend to others as well as ourselves. So I love this. Let's get into it. We Fall Down, Donnie McKirklin.
We fall down.
Hold on, hold on.
We get back up again.
All I say is
true. Yes, we are. Oh,
yes, we are. So I'm gonna fast forward a little bit because, you know, like there's a part of the song where I'm like just tapping into my warrior spirit where I'm down. I'm like, nah, I could get back up. I could. Oh, yeah. It's a ride around here. I'm like, oh nah, you gonna get back up, you gonna get back up. I just want to get back up right now. Ah. Oh man. Oh yeah. I just wanted to share something that works for me. I gather up a playlist filled with uplifting songs that, you know, praises God and strengthens my belief and keeps me calm and gives me that peace of mind. So that brings me to the end of my Keep the Faith playlist. And regardless if you are a believer or a non-believer, and regardless of your musical taste, no matter what genre, I encourage you to put together a playlist of songs that are inspiring to you. Feel free to share some songs and what they mean to you, because I would love to check them out. But with that being said, thank you for vibing out with me. I appreciate you. I love you, neighbors, and may peace be with you.